Hi, my name is Thorsten Schmidt and welcome back on the NMS Prime channel. Today I want to speak about CMTS provisioning. So first of all, when we want to talk about the topic, we need to know what a CMTS is. A CMTS is a cable modem termination system and it's the opposite device of a cable modem. So we want to jump in an architecture description, how an architecture for a cable modem termination system can look like, and how we build our networks with CMTSs. So first is about architecture. So of course, when you're an internet operator, the first thing that you need is an IP backbone. So for example, you have an IP backbone of 1 gigabit, you can buy it. And then this IP backbone is terminated in your headend. And the first thing that you then want to do is that, for example, here you add a normal switch. And then you will have the cable modem termination system, which will also be directly, or which could be also directly to the switch. So okay, the first thing that we see is that the CMTS requires an Ethernet input. So for example, here's just a normal gigabit link, and then we just provide the IP backbone to the cable modem termination system. And on the other side, the cable modem termination system, so the CMTS, has RF interfaces, and with these RF interfaces we can provide our HFC network. And on the other side, here are the end customers with the cable modems. So this is just really the basic architecture of a cable network. And now the topic of provisioning. How can we get these cable modems running? So the idea is, of course, you can configure many things on the CMTS itself, like the IP settings and all this kind of stuff. But what we do and what we recommend you is that you have a separate provisioning server who handles the entire process. And this is just really simple, because the idea is that we've put in here a server, and this server handles the entire process of getting the cable modems online. So for example, when the first cable modem is connected to your cable modem termination system, then it will request via DHCP, and the CMTS must told the cable modem or forwards the DHCP request to the provisioning server, and the provisioning server will reply them how they can get online, and so on and so on. I have made a separate video about it, what the process itself means, and there I was jumping into the process of a cable modem registration, and I explained it how you can use only open source tools to get these things running. So we from NMS Prime, we use normal Linux, which is all open source, and we've built our own provisioning system, which is called NMS Prime. You will find many informations on this channel and in the links below in the video. And this is the first thing that you need to know about the architecture of small networks. Of course, when the networks are getting bigger, what we see is that we provide not only one switch, for example. Here we have a cloud of many switches which deploy over our network. Maybe these switches are also connected with fiber in between, and then we have our CMTSs more deployed on the network. And then, of course, on a simple architecture like this, the entire routing stuff is done via the cable modem termination system. This is no problem for small networks, but if you get larger networks with many cable modem termination system, then we recommend that you have a separate routing infrastructure, which will also be connected to the switching layer, and then the routing infrastructure provides the backlink to your IP backbone. Again, if you want to know what happens inside this Linux server and what happens with open source tools and how you can use open source tools to get your first cable modem online, then check the video, which I will link in the description below. The next question is, how should you start with CMTS configuration? We have made an entire tutorial about how you can set up our system, the NMS Prime system, and there are some useful videos inside which you want to check out if you are more interested about the CMTS configuration. Maybe one general words first. What we do is that we connect the CMTS via a serial cable. I have made a video about it. I will also link it in the description. And then we've just provided some kind of default config for the cable modem termination system and tell them how they should work. The other stuff, which is in production when your system is running, then we use SNMP, Simple Network Protocol, to fetch the states of the CMTS and to set some small settings like frequencies, powers and stuff like this. And we also use it for the analysis part, how the cable modem termination system works. So there are also many videos about the CMTS analysis on this channel, so maybe just search for it. That's it for now. Thanks for watching. If you like the content, then give them a like. And if you are interested in more stuff, then don't forget to subscribe to our newsletter. Thanks for watching. We will see you in the next video. Bye.